Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to start one of the most important topic in Java. We call it a Java 8, right? So this Java 8 came long back, but to be very honest, these days if you'll go for any interview, Java 8 is the mandatory skill. If you don't know all the features of Java 8, straight away they will not select your resume. So you need to be very good in Java 8 feature, okay, and it is a requirement for any interview, and it's very powerful. By the way, it will help you to write a code in the functional way, which was not possible before Java 8, right? So with the Java 8, if you ask me, your collections frameworks, so when you are working with the collections framework with Java 8, it looks very simple. Your line of code will get reduced in few lines, okay? So we will see that, we'll see that one by one, and also we will try to understand why this Java 8 is very, very powerful, okay? So when I start with the Java 8, the first topic which I am going to talk is lambda expression. Like, what is this lambda expressions, how this is useful, and where this will use us, where this will help us, okay? So basically the lambda expressions you might have only seen in the math, right? When in your school days or in your college days, you would have seen that the lambda expressions. This is also the same lambda expressions through which we are going to write a functional style program. So basically the lambda expressions will help you to implement SAM interface. What does mean by SAM interface? The SAM interface means an interface which has only one abstract method. We call it as a SAM interface, right? And you can write the lambda expressions in the functional style. What is functional style? That we'll see that later, right? SAM stands for single abstract method, which you can see that. Now, we all are familiar with runnable interface, okay? So if you look at this runnable interface, it has only one method called run method, right? We don't have more method in runnable interface, and it is used to create a thread, right? Now focus on this annotations. What is this functional interface? If you look at the annotations at functional interface, so with Java 8, when Java 8 came, what they have done, they have changed this interface to a functional interface, which means for this interface, you can write a lambda expression, okay? And I will show you how through lambda expressions, your 5-10 lines of code will come in the single line, right? Which I will show you, right? Second thing is, we'll try to understand some more definitions of lambda expressions, right? Lambda expressions is used to provide the implementations of functional interface. Please remember this very important line, okay? The functional interface means the interface which has one method. You would have, by now you would have known of a lot of functional interface. Runnable is the functional interface. Your comparator is the functional interface, right? So there are much more functional interface we have in the Java, which slowly I will tell you one by one. And also I will tell you how this will help you to reuse your logic, what you write in one class. That was not possible before that, okay, before this functional programming. Now, if you look at my third point, lambda expression saves a lot of code lines. Look at here, it saves a lot of code lines, right? Lambda expression is very effective when you work with iterator, filter, and extract data from collections classes. As I said, it is very powerful feature. It will help you a lot when you work with collections framework. How it will help us, that we'll see that, because we have n number of feature in Java 8, and we need to learn a lot of things as a part of Java 8, and we need to be mastered in that, we need to be perfect in that, okay? Don't worry, when I started with Java 8, there was a lot of challenge. I will make sure that you will not face that challenge, okay? This is your syntax. So if you look at the first syntax, this is the typical lambda expression syntax. What is the parenthesis and then, you know, arrow mark and then curly braces? See, the parenthesis, whatever you see, basically that is nothing but through which you can supply the argument to the lambda expression. So whatever you are seeing, that is this parenthesis in which you can supply the argument to the lambda expressions, guys. Okay, you can supply argument to the lambda expressions, and whatever after arrow mark, whatever you have, this is the body of lambda expressions. Okay, so parenthesis is nothing but through which you can supply the data to the lambda expressions, and curly braces is the body of lambda expressions. You can see that here, this is the parameter, one parameter, this is the lambda expressions where I'm supplying the one parameter, then arrow, and then starting curly braces and ending curly braces. This is the lambda syntax. Here you have a lambda expressions, you are supplying the two argument, and then you have a body of the lambda expressions, right? You can see that here I have given the notes also. So this is nothing but the body of lambda expressions, and this is the argument to the lambda expressions, right? So we got a fair idea of what is lambda expressions, what is the syntax, but how it works, how we write everything, we'll see that slowly one by one. So in next video, I will start with some more concept of lambda expressions. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this.